In this video, I'm going to show you how to create your own AI personal assistant that you can interact with using Telegram. So you can go to Telegram and say, what is the latest update on the project that are still in progress? Also send an email to Mia asking her if she is available for a meeting tomorrow by 2 p.m. So we send that off on Telegram. Then we test the workflow here. You can see it has grabbed the audio, transcribed it, sent it to the AI agents. You can see it's hitting the contacts to get the contacts of Mia, hitting the projects to get the information. It has sent out an email, and on Telegram, it has given us a response. So let's see what that response is on Telegram. So if you come back here, you can see it has sent us the details of the latest projects, the projects that are still in progress. And it has also said, I have sent an email to Mia asking if she's available for a meeting. So if I go back to emails, I should say, meeting availability. Hi, Mia. I hope this meets you well. Okay, we'd like to know if you're available for a meeting by 2 p.m. And he said, best regards, Keys Assistant. So let's jump right in so that I can show you how you can build this from start to finish. So we can come back to this personal assistant workflow. The first thing this does every day is by itself, it has a trigger that starts here, trigger at 7 a.m. So what it basically does is that whenever you do this, it goes to grab all your calendar events. So whenever you come in the morning, every morning you can see, it says, hey, Kay, here are your calendar events for the day. Right, so that's what this basically does. 7 a.m. every morning, it grabs all your calendar events and it sends it to you on Telegram. The next workflow is basically, this is what you interact with on a daily basis to get information that you need to get. This is what obtains the message from your Telegram when you send it, either through voice or via chat. And you can see I've connected my Telegram credentials. You can always come here, say click credentials, put your access token from Telegram, and you'll be able to have that connection. Now, the next node, what this node does here is that this node ignores the stats. So usually if you come on Telegram, if I clear this chat, the first thing I'm going to see is start. Anytime you want to start a chat with a bot. So if you click on start, it's going to have this slash start. So what this is basically saying, anytime you see a message that is slash start, ignore it. So you can see if it is true, it came here, no operation, do nothing. Otherwise, it sends it to this place. So this is what is, this is the route node, right? It is checking if it is, if the voice message exists and if a text message exists. So what this is saying is that if a voice message exists, use this Telegram node. What this Telegram node does is basically it grabs that file, the voice file that that you created, then it sends it to OpenAI transcribe audio recording. What this node does is basically it, once that file has been grabbed, right, it transcribes it from audio to text. So if I come back to Telegram and I say hello, and if I test this, you're going to see it's going to grab that and it's going to transcribe that. You can see it has transcribed that of hello. This AI agent, this is the main engine of this. It expects a message, either a text message or the voice message that has been transcribed. Here, under the system message, you're adding all your input, system prompt. You're saying you are Anna, a helpful and professional assistant managing incoming Telegram messages on behalf of your boss, Kay. So your job is to identify the intent of the message, respond to each user message accurately and appropriately. So I've given this AI agent a number of tools, and I also give you some pretty short guidelines. If you look at this, the chat model here is OpenAI. You can open this. It's using GPT 4.1 mini, right? Then also adding memory. If you open the memory too, you can see that I gave it a context window of 20, which means it can remember as much of past interactions up to 20, right? The context window is 20. Now, the other thing is I gave it access. So you can give it access to your documents, right? I gave it access to my contacts. You can see, I said send an email to Mia. So immediately went to Mia, got a contact email, and sent off that information. You also have the projects, right? These are the projects. These are the ones in progress, the web design and the new office relocation. It was able to go, got the ones in progress and sent it back to me. You can see your invoices. I can tell you, I can ask questions about my invoices. So I can come back to Telegram and I can say, let's use text this time. How many invoices are overdue? Provide details. Right. So if I send this off and I test this, it's going to go through the test route, right? It's no longer, there's no audio here. So you can see it's hitting this guy. It has hit the invoice, it has gotten the invoice, and it has sent me back a message on Telegram. So you can see there are two invoices overdue for K. It was able to obtain all that the detailed information for those invoices and sent it back to me. And I also gave it a time too, right? Just to, for you to be able to know what's the current time, and I can ask it for any time for any part of the world. So I can say, what is the time in India now? Right? So if I test this workflow and I check my Telegram, it's going to hit the date and time too. And it's going to say the current time in IST is this on June 2nd. So it got that information. Now, the search is a tool that basically helps you search in internet. Hello, Anna. What is the latest news on sports today? So I expect it to transcribe again, then I expect it to hit the search tool to go get the latest news on sports. It gets that information, OpenAI chat model summarizes it, and then it sends it back to me on Telegram. So if we go back to Telegram, we should see all the major information it has given us on sports today. Now you also have the Gmail tool. This Gmail tool, what it basically does, this is what helps you send emails anytime you want to send an email. And let's open this Gmail tool. You can see set automatically, and I'm telling it, get the email recipient from AI, get the email subject from AI, right? The same thing for delete event. I'm telling it, get the ID of the event. So anytime I tell it to delete an event from the calendar, so if I look at the events on my calendar, I can go back to say, cancel all events in my calendar today. So if I go back and I test this workflow, I expect it to call this delete tool, right? It got the events in the calendar, all of them. Then it sent it to the delete tool to delete it. Then it will send me an update on what it did. All events scheduled for K have been canceled. So if I go back to my calendar too, you can see that the two meetings that I had scheduled today, they've all been canceled. Right. So if I go back here, this is used to create events, right? So if I ask it to create an event, so let's go back to Telegram, create an event for 3 p.m. with James to discuss POC on AI implementation today. Duration is 30 minutes. So let me send this off now and let's test that workflow again. It's supposed to go create the event. After creating the event, it's going to send us a message on Telegram. It's going to say the meeting with James to discuss has been created. So you can view it here, right? You can also tell it not to send you the link. It should just give you that information. So if I come back here, you can see immediately the meeting with James to discuss. So if I open this stuff, you can see the topic, meeting with James to discuss POC on AI implementation, and also added it as part of the notes to that email. Then finally, right, your information comes back when you get it from Telegram. Finally, you have the final node here. This is the node that responds to you, right? So the chat ID, you get this chat ID. You can see where I pulled my chat ID from. Yes, so you pull this chat ID so that it knows where it's going to respond to. Grab this. This is the output of the AI agent. You want it to be able to have that here so that it knows exactly what it's going to send up. So congratulations, this is your first AI personal assistant.